Hello everyone. Topic for today is equivalent circuit of induction motor. Induction motor has two parts, namely stator and rotor. Stator is the stationary member, whereas rotor is the rotating member. As we know that induction motor is also called as rotating transformer, the primary of transformer resembles the stator winding of induction motor, whereas secondary of transformer resembles the rotor. The equivalent circuit of rotor. We all know the equation. IR is equals to S times E2 divided by under root of R2 square plus S times X2 square. Here, we can observe that the left hand side of the equation, few modifications can be done. Dividing the left hand side of the equation by S, we get S times E2 by S divided by under root of R2 by S whole square plus S times X2 by S whole square. Here S get cancel out and we get this modified equation. Now according to this equation, our equivalent circuit of rotor would be this. In this, R2 by S is variable as slip depends. S stands for slip and slip depends upon the speed and speed depends upon the load. Therefore, this term is variable. Therefore, For further modification, R2 by S can be written as R2 by S plus R2 minus R2. Here R2 get cancelled out and we get our original term. Therefore, rearranging the term, we get R2 plus R2 by S minus R2. Then again rearranging the term, we get R2 plus R2 times in bracket 1 minus S minus 1. Here, R2 resembles the rotor copper loss, whereas R2 in bracket 1 minus S minus 1, this term resembles the mechanical load. Therefore, the equivalent circuit of the rotor modifies to this, where an extra variable resistance is added. The magnitude of that variable resistance is R2 times in bracket 1 minus S minus 1. Here, this is variable because it depends upon the load. As slip depends upon the speed, speed depends upon the load in induction motor. Now, as we know that the primary winding of transformer resembles the stator winding of induction motor, whereas the secondary winding of transformer resembles the rotor. Here is the equivalent circuit of transformer. And this is the equivalent circuit of rotor of induction motor that we have just derived. Therefore, by combining the primary side of transformer and the rotor side of induction motor, we get this equivalent circuit. Here, the parameters on the rotor side are taken to the primary side, hence denoted by dash. Whenever the parameters of secondary side are taken to primary side, they are denoted by dash, and the actual value is always divided by k square. Therefore, R2 dash is equals to R2 by k square. Similarly, X2 dash is equals to X2 by k square. And similarly for RL. In case of transformer, the no load current denoted by I0 or R0 is in the range of 5 to 10% of the full load current. Therefore, it is negligible. But in case of induction motor, the no load current is around 30% of the full load current. Hence, it cannot be neglected. But here, RC is the core loss component. The core loss component depends upon the voltage. And as voltage is constant, core loss is also nearly constant. Therefore, we can neglect it. And our final equivalent circuit of induction motor would be this. Thank you.